Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and this video is about getting rid of the flat look that most of us have when we first start a layout. Inspiration for my layout came from this picture of the north end of Edgar Thompson's steel mill, and this picture is from 1988 and it's on the cover of Steel Mill Railroads. Now, like most people, I did start with the plywood, and I mocked out how I wanted my layout to be with Unitrack and with some 2x4s. But instead of starting with a flat surface and building up from there, I like to start with the pink foam first. Get this at any hardware store. I prefer anywhere between an inch to 2 inch thickness. My layout's 30 inches deep, and I had to use the Woodland Scenics tool to get it pretty close to the edge. And then I needed to cut out the creek. So first I drew out where the creek would be. And then I used just a regular kitchen knife. And I cut out the creek. And I didn't cut myself, which is amazing. And then I used the liquid nails on the back. And I smoothed it all out. And once I held it down, I took some scrap pieces of styrofoam. And I made some of the elevations. Now back here, the creek's going to be kind of deep. That's the Turtle Creek. But up near the front, I just wanted a little bit, just a little bit of a drop down. And I will probably have some water in this low-lying area. This is going to be next to the Conrail main line. And it's a pretty desolate area, so I'll have maybe a couple trees, maybe just a little bit of water, just a little bit of runoff from the main line, and I just kind of drew out where the main line would go. Now I started stacking up where the hillside's going to be with more foam, but I had to make sure that I gave myself enough clearance so if I run like the larger cars, they don't catch on the hillside. And then I decided to go for a road trip. And look at this. The bridge piers are not fully exposed. Most of the time when we make scenes with bridge piers, we show the whole pier. But if you look, the pier actually looks like it's cutting into the hillside. And I decided I was going to scratch build my own piers. Now this, being 2017, that was all the vegetation had grown, but I'm modeling 88 where there's still a lot of fill there. So this looks pretty close to how the land was. And more foam, and I filled it in with some paper because now I'm going to use the plaster cloth. Woodland Scenic, Scenic Express, both great companies. This is nothing out of the ordinary. You can see a million scenery videos. Most people, this is what they use. I wanted to cover up some of those creases, especially, where you could tell that it's two pieces of foam. I want it all to blend together. The backdrop I'm going to do last, because I don't want to get it. Look, I make a mess. So I was not going to have this against a nice blue backdrop. And I even cut some areas down for, there's going to be an access road. I can't stand that color pink. So I decided, well, this was drying. I painted the pink with just household latex brown. And then, of course, I love my Sculpta mold from Scenic Express. And I mixed it up. Now this is a fill. You could tell this is not natural area, that the railroad had created this fill for the elevations. And I just used the brush. Now it doesn't even look like this was ever flat. And there's my scratch-built pier. That's one little piece of styrene that I just kind of scored some lines on. I didn't want the whole thing covered with foam. Or not foam, you know what I mean. The shrubbery and bushes and stuff. So I left some of it exposed. And I figured I want the whole thing to be green instead of brown, so I went back over where the thicker vegetation is going to be in the trees, and I did that in green in case something falls off. It's not too noticeable, kind of blends in. And there's the access road. And here's a good progress shot. And I didn't even put the main lines down yet. Just did my cork. I do things different than everybody. Most people will have a plywood and track before they have scenery. I love scenery. This is, to me, is more fun running a train on a finished scene. Yes, that's my 1940s train. Now, with the fill being created by the railroad, they used a lot of cinders. And that's where the black comes from. Hey, look, this is what I was telling you about, where I just cut down a little bit, just a little bit, and I'll probably add water there. And now, with real dirt and some scenery material, the bridge pier blends in, looks so much closer to how the prototype was. Always mix your colors of scenery material. And you can see where the vegetation is starting to take over. And it creates a much more interesting scene than just plywood. And here's where the creek's going to go. I still got to scratch build a whole new bridge. But there's like three different layers of scenery here. The creek, the ground. Like, look at the picture again. I mean, I got a long way to go, but I think it's a pretty good start. So you got the main line up here. Then you got the Conrail main line here. You got that low-lying area where there's going to be probably some water. See, over here you have the creek, and it's going to take a little while, but I'll be working on that soon. And then the ramp that goes, I think this is the low grade that'll take you down into the yard. This will be the valley yard. All right, I hope this video gave you some ideas and some inspiration. And be sure to check out my website, djstrains.com, where I'm probably going to post some more progress photos, along with maybe some pictures of the rail area. A lot of cool stuff on there coming up. Well, I hope you enjoyed it, and get the modeling going, and get that pink foam, and start working your way down with the scenery. Make it interesting. Take care. Don't cut yourself. Seriously, don't do it.